Yo, what's up guys, you're watching Zillocity and today I'm going to show you a breakdown, a comparison of chicken versus mutton versus paneer. So as you know that for non-vegetarians, chicken is the widely consumed protein source, and especially for the people that are going to the gym, chicken becomes the very easy option to get the protein intake, and mutton is another alternative for protein intake for non-vegetarians. But for vegetarians, sadly, there are not many protein sources, and vegetarians do have to rely on dairy for a large part to get their protein intake. And paneer is widely consumed by vegetarian people who go to the gym and lift weights and at least are taking care of their fitness. Paneer, they have to rely on that, right? So I'm going to break down why chicken or mutton or paneer, whatever, is healthier and why it's better for you. So watch the video to know more. So before we make a comparison, let's break down individually of what the contents are. In this situation, we have three things to compare: chicken, mutton, and paneer. So let's see what individually the contents are. So starting with chicken, 100 grams of chicken boneless breast piece is going to give you about 25 grams of protein, 0 grams of carbs, and about 1 or 2 grams of fat per 100 grams. And if you were to have chicken drumstick or the leg piece, then it's going to give about 18 grams of protein, around 0 grams of carbs again, and you'd get about 15 grams of fat from that leg piece, okay, one leg piece if you have. Now moving on to mutton. Mutton has about 18 grams of protein per 100 grams, 0 gram of carbs, and 13 grams of fat per 100 grams, okay. So if you were to have mutton over chicken boneless, then you're going to have to balance your fat accordingly. I'm not saying that fat is unhealthy and you should not have fat. Whoa, if you have fat, you're going to gain fat. It's not that, okay? If you have more calories than you are supposed to, then you might gain fat. And I'm not saying you will, but that's the thumb rule, okay? More calories than you should be eating over time, you're going to gain fat. Less calories than what you should be eating over time gives you fat loss. And if you were to be on a ketogenic diet, that's a completely different story altogether, because the whole point of a ketogenic diet is to get the energy from fat. So if you are on a ketogenic diet, then you can enjoy your mutton as much as you would like to. You can enjoy higher amounts of fat, but then you will be reducing your carbohydrate intake drastically. So that's another, you'll have to kuch paane ke liye kuch khona padta hai. It's really suitable for the ketogenic diet. So if you want to enjoy more fat, you'll have to reduce carbs. If you want to enjoy more carbs, then you have to reduce fat. That's how it works. Moving on to paneer. 100 grams of paneer is going to give you about 18 grams of protein again, about 1 gram of carbs, and then you're going to get about 20 grams of fat. So about 265 calories in total if you were to eat about 100 grams of paneer, okay? My point here is not that fat is bad. Again, coming back to the point of fat, because paneer has more fat. If you were to eat carbs in your entire day, like if you want to enjoy about either some rice or roti, whatever, okay, you'll have to balance your fat intake accordingly. So if you were to have grilled chicken with about 1 or 2 spoons of ghee or butter, you will be getting only like 6 to 7 grams of fat per meal, right? On the contrary, if you were to eat mutton or paneer, which has higher amounts of fat, then if you add ghee or butter, then the total amount of fat that you eat in a meal, even with 100 grams of paneer, it's going to go about 26 to 27 grams of fat. And then you'll have to balance your carbohydrate intake accordingly. So if you are a vegetarian, paneer becomes one of the very few protein sources to have. And because even in vegetarian protein sources like dal and peas and beans, etc., you'll still get a lot of carbs along with the protein. So you don't get a lot of protein like you do in paneer or milk, right? If you want to have paneer, then you'll have to compromise a little bit on your carbohydrates if you want to lose weight. If you want to gain weight, please have as much paneer, as much mutton, or whatever you have in the entire day. The whole point here is prioritize your protein intake. Even if you want to lose weight, prioritize your protein intake. Even if you want to gain weight, prioritize your protein intake. Protein intake is basically the main thing that you should focus on in the entire day. Carbs and fats, you can balance it as per your caloric intake the entire day. Again, on a ketogenic diet, less carbs, a lot of fat. On a normal lifestyle, balanced amount of carbs and fats, right? Coming to the conclusion of this video, I would say that chicken breast piece is pretty much the best choice to have if you want to maintain an all-around balanced lifestyle in which you also have a little bit of carbs and you have a little bit of fat and you have a good amount of protein and you just enjoy your lifestyle. I personally do not like going to the extremes like no fruits, no fat. I don't like these things. You should eliminate fat or eliminate carbs, I wouldn't personally prefer doing that, because I believe in a lifestyle which is all round, which I feel comfortable doing. It's not about balance. Balance is different for everyone, but then it's all about your comfort. And I'm talking about a healthy lifestyle which includes your mental health as well. If you don't like removing carbs from your diet, and if I tell you, no, that's the only way, you have to do keto if you want to lose weight, then you'll be like, oh my god, I'll go insane if I don't eat carbs. Then that's what happens in India, because there's about 70% of the items that you have in Indian households are carbohydrates, right? So a little bit of lifestyle change can make a great impact in your life. And as I told, prioritize your protein intake if you're a vegetarian, include paneer, balance your carbohydrate intake. So I hope you understood and you found this video helpful. If you did, you know what to do. Hit the like button, share this video with as many people as you can. I would really be grateful for it. And subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. So I'll see you in the next video. And now I'm signing off.